I'm going to start at a poem called Slag. One blue alum simmers on the stove, steam rising like a slow train up and over the mill line. Still life burnt in coal, black heat. Skin cold split in the third shift. The radiator hisses. Flurries dance on the wind in spun meadows. She presses her hands to the hot pipes, looks out across the Pittsburgh gray, soaking it in, spreading it like a blanket across her memory, thick like miner's dust, an iron door. She wears gloves to bed, wakes to the itch of wool, startled by how her fingers feel like somebody else's, how rough they've grown like a man's inside her winter skin. She pictures the man, bright inside her childhood dream hat, like the light at the end of a shaft. He is twice her size and she can't see around him. Warm bourbon breath that melts the snow before it lands. The game will be played in the big wooden house. The kitchen floor freshly mopped, though no one lives there. She will like the game because he made it up just for her. She puts her hands in his flannel pockets and follows. The sky is wide, the day endless. Somewhere, a kettle whistles. The man's fingers are dry and hot as he teaches her how to play. When he kisses her, she kisses back. It is freezing without her gloves and underwear, but his hands are a furnace, and that is enough. He doesn't ask her not to tell. Instead, he points to the smokestacks across the river still burning, says how the blue fire from the molten ore can singe your skin off, leave you cold like steel. Tells her she'll never feel anything.